Students, I am again with you with the remaining part of the lesson, the gift of chappals. See, in the last video, we saw that Dadiji tells Ravi to send the beggar out of the house as they have been feeding him for the last 1 week. The beggar hears the mother shout, and before Ravi tells anything, he says that he will go. But as it was very hot outside, he wanted to take some rest and then go. He explains that tar has already melted and his feet had blisters. Now, further, I don't know, said Ravi. Mine are too small to fit his feet, or I would have given them to him, and his feet were larger than Mridu and Meena's. The beggar was shaking out his upper cloth and tightening his dhoti. He raised his eyes and looked fearfully at the road gleaming in the afternoon heat. He needs something on his feet, Meena said, her big eyes filling. It's not fair. So, as you know that the children were concerned about, he did not have chappals and they were concerned. But Ravi said his feet were too big to fit any one of them. So their chappals could not fit his feet. And that was the reason they were not able to gift their chappals to the old man. But they were concerned that he needed something. He cannot go out like that. In the meantime, the old beggar picks up his dhoti, tightens his dhoti and gets ready to go out. Let's see further. Shh, said Ravi. I'm thinking about it. Blubbering, it's not fair. It's not fair. Isn't going to help. In 2 minutes, he'll be frying his feet on that road. What he needs is a pair of chappals. So, where do we get them? Come. Let's search the house. He pushed Mridu, Meena into the house. So boys and girls, the three children, Mridu, Meena and Ravi, are concerned about the old beggar. And they are concerned so much because it's very hot outside. The old beggar is ready to leave the house. He is about to go out. And now the children start saying, it's not fair, it's not fair. He will fry out his feet. It is so hot that his feet will be fried up. So something should be done. That was the consensus among the three. Let's see what happens further. Just as she stepped into the veranda, Mridu's eyes fell on the old looking chappals she had noticed when she arrived. Ravi, she whispered to him, whose are those? Ravi turned and glanced at the shabby looking
But sturdy old sleepers, he beamed and nodded. These are just the right size, he said, picking them up. Mridu and Meena followed him nervously back into the garden.
Okay, do you remember when Mridu reached the house and when Ravi dragged her in, tried to drag her in? She had said one thing, let me remove my chappals. And when she was removing her chappal, she saw one more pair of chappal already kept over there that was quite old, and even all the toes were marked on those chappals. When your chappals get quite old, your toes get almost printed on them. That was the condition of those chappals. Now they all three agree that is the right size, and these chappals could be gifted to the old beggar. Let us see what happens further.
Here, said Ravi to the beggar, dropping the slippers in front of the old man. Wear these and don't come back. The beggar stared at the slippers, hurriedly flung his towel over his shoulder, pushed his feet into them and left, muttering a blessing to the children. In a minute, he had vanished around the corner of the street. The music master came out of the house and took an unappreciative look at the three of them sitting quietly under the tree, playing marbles. Then he searched for his chappals in the veranda where he had put them.
So boys and girls, the music lesson is over. The music master comes out. He glances at those three, the three children who were playing over there. See, one was learning violin and three were playing outside. So he doesn't give a pleasant glance at them. जैसे होते हैं ना उनकी नजरों में ये निठल्ले बेकार वे कैसे बैठे हैं और वो देखो कितने समझदार हैं अंदर सीख रही है इस तरह की फीलिंग के साथ he gives a glance at them. Then he searches for the chappals, but the chappals are not there. Let's see what happens further.
Lalli, he called after a few moments. She hurried up to him. Have you seen my chappals, my dear? I remember having kept them here. Ravi, Mridu, Meena silently watched Lalli and the music teacher search every corner of the veranda. He scurried around, looking over the railing and crouching near the flower pots to look between them. Brand new they were. I went all the way to Mount Road to buy them. He went on saying, they cost a whole month fees. Do you know?
अब मास्टर जी ने तो ये कहना शुरू कर दिया. Brand new they were. And you know what was the condition of those chappals. But he says, brand new they were. And I went all the way to Mount Road. Mount Road is it? Yes, Mount Road to buy those chappals. He starts telling the whole story. How he bought those chappals. And they were brand new according to him. Now he is not finding them. Let's see what happens further.
Soon, Lalli went in to tell her mother. Rukumani appeared, looking harassed, with Pati following her. Where could they be? It's really quite upsetting to think someone might have stolen them. So many vendors come to the door, worried Patti. Rukumani caught sight of Ravi, Madhu and Meena sitting under the tree. "Have you children?" she began, and then seeing they were curiously quiet, went on more slowly. "Seen anyone lurking around the veranda?" A sharp V-shaped line had formed between her eyebrows. Another straight, tighter one appeared in place of her usually soft, pleasant mouth. Rukumani was angry. Thought Mridu was a shiver. She wouldn't be so upset if she knew about the poor beggar with pores on his feet. She tried to tell herself.
तो बच्चों तीनों लेडीज बाहर आती हैं और देखती हैं कि चप्पल यहीं थी. फिर पति कहती हैं कि बहुत सारे लोग आते हैं, वेंडर वगैरह भी आते हैं, कहीं वो तो नहीं उठा ले गए. तभी रुकुमनी की नजरें पड़ती हैं तीनों बच्चों पर और उन्होंने एक सेंटेंस बोलना शुरू ही किया था, क्या तुमने, और फिर वो उनके फेस देख के थोड़ा पास जाके बोलती हैं, देखा किसी को? और इस सेंटेंस के पूरा होने तक बहुत गुस्सा हो चुकी है. यहाँ तक कि उनका जो नॉर्मली प्लीजिंग फेस होता था, आज उस पे एक लाइन ऐसे खिंची हुई है और वी बना हुआ है गुस्से में. जब भी आपका गुस्सा होता है तो आपका भी तो चेहरा बदल जाता है. हाँ, तो उनका भी बदला हुआ था. मेरा, हाँ, मेरा भी बदलता है. अभी मैं खुश हूँ तो कोई लाइन नहीं है ना मेरे चेहरे पे. और जब क्लास में गुस्सा करता था कोरोना से पहले तो आई हैड वी एंड समटाइम्स ऑल दोज लाइंस विच शोड माई एंगर. सो एवरीबडी हैज दिस. ओके, आइए देखते हैं आगे क्या होता है.
टेकिंग अ डीप ब्रेथ सी क्राइड, Rukumani, देर वॉज अ beggar here, poor thing, he had such a boils on his feet. So, said Rukumani grimly, turning to Ravi, you gave the music master chappal to that old beggar who turns up here. Children these days, groaned Patti. Amma, didn't you tell me about Kaun, who gave away everything he had, even his gold earrings? He was so kind and generous.
अब देखिए यहाँ बात आती है बड़ों की कथनी और करनी में फर्क देखते हैं बच्चे, और वहीं से उनको बड़ा अकवर्ड लगता है. यहाँ मृत्यु साहस जुटा करके बताने की कोशिश करती है, Rukumani वो बैगर को हमने वो चप्पल दे दी, उसके पैरों पर छाले पड़े हुए थे. तो बहुत स्टैनली Rukumani बोलती, देन वॉट, आप म्यूजिक मास्टर की चप्पल उसको दे देंगे, उस भिखारी को? इस पर बच्चे ये भी याद करते हैं, दादी जी आपको याद है आपने कर्ण की कहानी सुनाई थी हमें, कर्णा इन महाभारत, who gave away all he had, even his earrings, कवच और कुंडल सब कुछ दे दिया था. आपने तो वो कहानी सुनाई थी कर्ण की, आप कितना दानवीर था आप खुद कहते हैं, और हमने वो चप्पल बस दान दे दी तो गुस्सा कर रहे हैं सब. बच्चों का सवाल जायज तो था. देखते आगे क्या होता है.
Silly, snapped Rukmani. Karna didn't give away other people's things. He only gave away his own. But my chappals wouldn't have fitted the beggar's feet. Ravi rushed rashly on, and Amma, if they did fit, would you really not have minded? Ravi, said Rukmani, very angry now. Go inside this minute.
अब यहां देखिए, दादी जी कहती है, अरे तो कर्ण अपनी चीजें दिया करता, दूसरों की थोड़े ही दान दिया करता। इस पर रवि कहते हैं, अच्छा दादी जी वैसे एक बात बताओ, वैसे हमारी चप्पल फिट नहीं हो रही थी, लेकिन अगर हम अपनी भी दे देते तो आप झूठ मत बोलो कि गुस्सा नहीं होती, तो भी आप गुस्सा होने वाले थे। इस पर बीच में मम्मी डांट लगाती है बहुत गुस्से में, चलो गेट इन, इसी मिनट अंदर जाओ तुम। ऐसा कह के रवि को भेज देते हैं अंदर, देखते हैं आगे क्या होता।
शी हरिडली इंडोर्स brought out Gopu Mama's hardly worn new chappals. These should fit you, sir. Please put these on. I'm so sorry. My son has been very naughty. The music master's eyes lit up. He put them on, trying not to look too happy. Well, I suppose these will have to do. These days children have no respect for elders. What to do? Ah, Hanuman incarnate. Only Rama can save such a naughty fellow. Rukmani's eyes flashed. She didn't seem to like Ravi being called a monkey, even a holy monkey. She stood stiff and straight by the front door. It was clear she wanted him to leave quickly. When he had clattered off in his new chappals, she said, Mridu, come in and have some tiffin. Honestly, how do you children think of such things? Thank God your Gopu Mama doesn't wear his chappals to work. As she walked towards kitchen with Mridu and Veena, she suddenly began to laugh. But he is always in such a hurry to throw off his shoes and socks and get into his chappals as soon as he comes home. What's your mama going to say this evening when I tell him I gave his chappals to the music master?
Now, बच्चे दे चुके हैं, गोपू मामा की चप्पल याद आ गई और तुरंत मम्मी जी चप्पल लेकर आती हैं और गुरु जी को दे देती हैं नई चप्पल। और आप याद कीजिए गुरुजी की चप्पल कैसी थी। मास्टर जी को अंदर अंदर बड़ी खुशी होती है और हिज आईज लिट अप, लेकिन उसने खुशी छिपा ली। इनको पता नहीं लगना चाहिए मेरी इतनी पुराने चप्पलों के लिए मैं खुश हो रहा हूं, ये तो बिल्कुल नई आ गई। और कहा ठीक है चलेगा, कोई बात नहीं, काम तो चलाना पड़ेगा। ये आजकल के बच्चे भी ना बिल्कुल हनुमान हो गए हैं, इनको तो कोई राम ही वश में कर सकता है। ऐसा कह के और वो तो चलते बने, लेकिन मृदु और मीना को ये बातें अच्छी नहीं लग रही थी कि कोई रवि को बंदर कहकर पुकारे। भले ही वो बंदर भगवान के रूप में हो, लेकिन उन बच्चों को अच्छा नहीं लग रहा था और उनको लग रहा था, खासकर मृदु को, कि ये तुरंत यहाँ से जाना चाहिए, और वो बड़ी स्टिफ वहाँ खड़ी हो गई। मास्टर जी चले गए। जाने के बाद आपको याद होगा रवि तो पहले ही अंदर जा चुका, तो अब मम्मी जी ने मृदु और मीना को भी अपने साथ अंदर बुला लिया, और अंदर चलते चलते उन्होंने कहा, शुक्र है गोपू मामा चप्पल पहन के ऑफिस नहीं जाते, उनकी चप्पल मिल गई। और फिर वो जोर से हंसती हैं, लेकिन एक बात है, हंसी आ गई उनको। जैसे ही वो आते हैं, शूज उतार के फेंक देते हैं, उनको तुरंत चप्पल चाहिए। उस समय मैं क्या कहूंगी कि आपकी चप्पल बच्चों ने भिखारी को दे दी। हंसते हुए सारे अंदर चले जाते हैं। कहानी का यहाँ पे अंत हो जाता है, लेकिन हम सब के लिए एक संदेश छोड़ जाती है कहानी, कि कर्ण की कहानी सुना देना बड़ा आसान है, लेकिन थोड़ा करके भी दिखाना चाहिए, विशेषकर हम बड़ों को। हम बड़े जब करेंगे तभी तो बच्चे सीखेंगे। बच्चे बहुत अच्छे ऑब्जर्वर होते हैं, वो भाषण से कुछ नहीं सीखते, वो हमारे एक्शंस को देखते हैं और हमारे एक्शन से सीखते हैं। इसीलिए हम सबको इस बात का ध्यान रखना चाहिए कि वी आर बीइंग ऑब्जर्व्ड ऑल द टाइम्स, एंड देयर शुड नॉट बी अ ग्रेट डिफरेंस बिटवीन द सेड एंड द डन। इट शुड नॉट बी ईजियर सेड देन डन। विद दीज वर्ड्स आई क्लोज अप दिस चैप्टर। I advise you to finish up all the exercises today itself, so that tomorrow we can have a conference over some of the issues from the chapters. Thanks for joining.